Question 27 in the ACER blue paper. Question 27. Of the following three circuits, all of the cells and globes are identical and the internal resistances of the cells are negligible. Which of the following globes will be the brightest? So the brightest globe will have the most current flowing through it, and that is our mission. Today, we're going to find the globe with the most current flowing through it. So let's start with circuit one. We have a total resistance of R on 2. So this is a parallel circuit. If you just use the parallel circuit total resistance equation, you'll get 1 on R plus 1 on RT is equal to 1 on R plus 1 on R. So that means that you get 1 on RT is equal to 2 on R. So therefore, RT is equal to R on 2. So the total resistance is therefore R on 2 for this circuit. If we sub that into our V equals IR equation, well, what we get is we get the total current is equal to 2V on R. So over here, the total current is 2V on R. But as we know, when we have a parallel circuit, the current gets split up. In this case, since we have two branches in the parallel circuit, we're going to have half of the current in each branch, half of the, sorry, total current in each branch. So therefore, the current flowing through each globe is going to be 2V on R divided by 2, which is equal to V on R. Let's go on to circuit 2. So the total resistance is equal to 2R. Pretty simple, it's a series circuit. You just add the resistances of each globe. And therefore, the total current is going to be V on 2R using V equals IR equation. So the current flowing through each globe is equal to V on 2R. So we've got to find out the total resistance of this circuit. It's a little bit harder, but not impossible. So if you're observant, you'll notice that this part in parallel is exactly the same as what we had before. So we can sort of port across this total resistance and say that the effective resistance of this parallel part is R on 2. So what we've essentially got, therefore, is we've got a series circuit whereby we have one resistor which has a resistance of R, and another part which has an effective resistance of R on 2. So if we just add those together, counting them as a series circuit, what you'll get is 3R on 2 for the total resistance. Using that and subbing that into the V equals IR equation, what you'll get is the total current is equal to 2V on 3R. So therefore, the current flowing through resistor 3 is going to be 2V on 3R because that has the total resistance. And since the resistor 4 is part of the parallel circuit, it's going to receive half of the total current, and that is therefore V on 3R. So overall, the globe that is going to flow globe brightest will be globe 1 because it has the most current flowing through it. So A is the correct answer.